into fight two. Will be fought at a catch weight of 54 kilos, 3 rounds, 3 minutes each. Please make welcome to the blue corner, Cassandra Hay.
Okay, here we have Cassandra Hay fighting out of MMA PFT. Originally hailing from Penrith. I saw her at the back, she looked absolutely in shape and raring to go. So I believe you signed off her gloves. any little advice given it at the end there, Michael?
Well, mate, you know me, I've got tricks of all trades, eh? I do it all, mate, I do it all. But yes, no, I was at the back with them, and they're ready to go. I can tell you that. I was talking to both, wrapped their hands, signed off their gloves, and she couldn't wait to get out there.
Yeah, and sitting a little bit the elder statesman in terms of being 38, making her MMA debut here at the moment. And it can come down to just that experience piece. Not everyone gets in a life in a fighting at the same time frames, and she obviously has something to prove to herself. So great to see in that sense. Throw over yourself, Adam. Anything you want to add in there?
Well, I've got another one here with some Muay Thai experience, so I'm hoping we're going to see some more solid striking like we did in the last round, last fight. And I'd also love to see her favourite rear naked choke for a good finish.
Yeah, and once again, she's working on becoming a more well-rounded fighter, which, you know, comes down to base, but looking at the stables that they have for the notable fighters, so Olivia Kukma, Jesse Senator, and Filane Mascata. But there's just so many skilled fighters they've got, and yeah, really looking forward to how this one shapes up tonight. I do like the song choice, though.
And welcoming the red corner opponent,
that's true, yes.
Please make welcome Zara Riley.
Yeah, I'm not. Didn't realise that. That's sung by Rihanna. Bitch, better have my money. It's not in my playlist, but now I understand why that Michael had his wallet out trying to get me some money. Here we go. We've got Zara Riley now coming out of Gamebred Academy. A little bit more junior in regards to age, fighting at 23. And obviously, after seeing the last spot, we know what to expect from the Gamebred team. They come prepared.
Definitely come prepared. Their team, I've fought Looney myself, and the way that they train, mate, oh, damn.
As far as tough gyms go, Gamebred is up there.
You can tell that they train very conditioned gyms, like we saw in the last fight.
Yeah, and that's the other thing as well, is they've got so many experienced people and a huge stable of fighters. Not only is it Gamebred, but you've also got the Ignite teammate partnership as well, so very, very much got skill set across the board. But this is what I'm really liking here. I'm looking at Cassandra, and she's really comfortable talking to her team. Just those little last-minute fight pro things. It's a sign of respect. I love that.
It's good. It's great.
Looks calm, so she's coming in.
Ladies
as one
and gentlemen, and this fight proudly brought to you by the XFC family at 40 Winks Oxley. Introducing first our blue corner fighter. She weighed in at 53.5 kilos, making her debut fight this evening. Trained out of MMA Family Fight Team, trained by Renata Sabotic, please make welcome Cassandra Payday! Hey! And squaring off against the red corner opponent, weighing in at 53.9 kilos with an undefeated record of one fight, one win. She's training at Gamebred Academy. She's training under Jason Lonergan. Please make welcome Zara the Hippie Riley. Ladies and gentlemen, this fight will be overseen by referee Peter Heckmott. Here we go.
I love the two different styles. You've got Cassandra really calm and relaxed, just soaking up. And Zara looks like she's going to a party. She's ready to dance and have fun. I want to see how they bring that into this fight here now. So they touch gloves beforehand. They're not doing it at the start of the fight. That's okay.
They're really comfortable in there.
Some really strong kicks by Cassandra there.
Bit of a slip there. Excellent getting up off the cage. Yeah. Off the ground. Using the cage to get up.
Yeah, and Peter Hickmont, one of the best in the business there, basically telling Zara that she wasn't allowed to do any striking at that stage, just due to the fact that Cassandra still had a hand on the mat, which means they're classed as a grounded opponent.
I was really trying to take her down. I think those leg kicks would have... Ooh, I can hear them.
Those leg kicks are stinging.
Nice.
She's slow.
Hands.
Oh, there's punches Zara and bunches there. I like that Zara clenched up then just to try and take away that attacking range. I can see the payday nickname coming in here from Cassandra. She is throwing everything. It's like Zara owes her money. But Zara's doing a really good job here in trying to keep the distance. Closing that distance piece just to take away that striking power from Cassandra.
Yeah, those leg kicks would make me, yeah.
Yeah, and Gamebred are really, really good at cage work. So looking forward to seeing how this works. So it's who unlocks the puzzle first.
Being the one against the cage, the puzzle's a bit harder. Excellent reversal there.
Oh, nice.
Fantastic.
Great work.
You can tell they've got different game plans. Cassandra looks like she wants to strike. Zara looks like she wants to grapple.
Yeah. And the other thing is they're both C-class fighters, so if they do get to the ground, they can't strike to the head anyway.
It's great cage work by both these ladies.
It certainly is, and she's almost got herself into a guillotine there. It's like a 10-finger choke.
Oh, it's like a 10-finger choke.
He's going for it.
But she's just prying the hands open.
Zara's using the cage to release some of that leverage there.
Wow.
Yeah, that's super tight. That's so tight. And the other thing is the oxygen depletion part from that there. It's at this stage, it's just suffocating oxygen, so the choke's not quite there.
She was doing good fighting the hands.
Oh, did a great job.
Wow.
Ooh. It's just how much oxygen was sucked out from that piece there. I like this idea. Beautiful single leg. But Cassandra's done a great defense there on keeping that leg on the outside to prevent the takedown.
That was an active
first round. Ladies and gentlemen, proudly brought to you by Havoc.
I wanted to tap four. That was really tight.
It wasn't just the fingers too. Like, you could see the way that she was pressuring her head against the cage was also.
And here you can see Cassandra's just throwing those punches in bunches. Like, she threw so many in there. And here's that choke. She actually was using the cage to a disadvantage for Zara. But Zara's activeness and being able to move around just kept that oxygen level coming through.
Zara stayed nice and calm, fought the hands. She was breathing really well. But yeah, I don't know how she done that here.
It takes a good mindset to be able to stay calm in that situation and think about what you have to do to not get choked out.
Exactly.
So you can see that the grappling is solid.
See, I've always worked that tapping twice works, but I'm not sure that's what you wanted to do right there.
No, this place, no.
That's my favourite escape.
Yeah, it works every time. No, that's really, really tough. So, and from here, we'd like to see how the fighters now, what their corners have told them and how they adjust to this to the second round right now. So I think Zara's really happy with it in terms of the grappling component, so see how she weaves that into her game plan right now. But Cassandra's throwing so much power.
Sandra's absolutely moving forward.
He's throwing everything
pressure.
In
there. Oh,
certainly is. It's also really difficult being in the corner.
Great reversal there by Cassandra.
And I was about to finish that saying it's being the other person's corner, because you had all the commentary like trying to do the opposite. Nice reversal again.
Nice.
We're going to see it again.
I don't think any of these girls like being stuck against this cage.
They're doing a great job here. And Peter Hickmont, best in the business. Watching on closely.
and they're just reversing each other's. Every time they make a move, the other one reverses it.
Yeah, Cassandra's locked her hands up at this stage, and what I like there is they didn't let go of her hands until she knew she was in a strong position, where the person being active on the other side is actually closing that distance up very well.
But there's a lot of work that goes into the cage as well.
It's so tiring, isn't it? I love wrestling. As soon as I'm told it's cage work, I'm busy for some reason.
They're viciously fighting for that double unhook.
Yeah.
Has she got a single? Is she going to get it?
Nice sprawl out there.
And she's going
under the chin again.
It's a psycho choke punch.
I guess not let's try punches because they're in C class.
On the back. She's got to get those hooks in to help control those hips.
This is where the C class component is quite good to see. But the problem is this one here kind of makes it a little bit hard to do anything offensively when you're on top in this position. Outside of striking in terms of the body, but it's a much smaller target to hit. So Zara's got to basically do some movement here to be able to move. Yep. She's got to fix it. Because striking to the body is just as bad as the head here. If she doesn't clean up the position, Peter will finish this fight.
Peter gave a warning. She's staying active enough.
So this is the point where she either got to give up her back, and then she's got the problem with her neck. A bit hard to see from this angle what she's doing, but this point here, she's got the double hooks in. Grapevining out.
It's 10 seconds
left.
She can hold it.
She needs to fight.
Needs to do something, or Peter's going to wave this off. She's currently going
time!
And from here, it's what can Game Bread do for Zara to get her head back in the game? That's pretty it's pretty hard ending a round in a being dominated in a certain position. But it's how do you pick yourself up and realize coming out that last round, it all starts again.
They're both pretty equally skilled against the cage. The cage work is phenomenal. I think that with Zara's corner, they might be telling her, let's keep your boxing and your MMA, let's get your striking, let's really use that. The cage work is very equal, and I don't think it's in her favour to land back on her back again.
Yeah, and similar thing, I'm not sure, but it's Zara's doing a great job getting the takedowns. It's the scramble. It's who's winning the scramble. And Mikey, this is something I've obviously from watching your fighting over the years. You're never intent on just sitting there on your back. Like you scramble so well, and that's what I think the Game Bread team will be telling their charge right now is, when you get to the ground, secure that position.
I definitely want to see what the game plan is now leading up in this third round. I think Cassandra's leading the scorecards.
Cassandra's certainly throwing all the punches in there. And she's causing some damage on that as well. There's a bit of a mouse coming up on the right-hand side of Zara's eye.
Good striking.
And they're not getting tired either, so they're quite a gas tank there. There's no such thing as a boring girls fight. I've never seen one yet.
Never.
I can see Cassandra having this video edited with pay me my money.
Yeah. Tell you what, I wouldn't want to get hit by one of her leg kicks. They're looking like they're doing some damage over there.
Yeah, she certainly has not missed leg day. But both girls are doing a great job here, just striking and trading off of each other.
So Zara's trying to counter.
Zara's trying to control that center cage a lot more. You can really notice she's trying not to take
third
a backward
and
step,
final round, ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for your fighters.
So Cassandra's still throwing a lot of the punches. A bit of the power's come out of the punches now, but she's still throwing a hell of a lot in there.
They're both being very patient as well. There's no bum rushing or anything. Trying to keep their distance good.
No panic.
Oh, big shot, Zara.
Nice.
That was a nice uppercut there.
Got a flexion, needs to just slip, try and find that counter hit.
There she goes, good takedown by Cassandra.
Off double.
Beautiful work, and she's about to pass the guard in a second. Beautiful head pressure as well to pin Zara's head to the ground up against the gutter. It's a horrible position to get out of. Zara will be looking to use the cage to try and walk up, but at this stage, Cassandra's stopping that by locking her feet together. She's using that left hook really, really well. But she's just walked herself in a mount.
Got about 20 more seconds.
Strong. Zara has to either turn to the cage and maybe get to her back. Onto the cage and get up.
10 seconds remaining. Put your hands together.
Oh, she got herself in Kezi.
Nice.
Time.
What an awesome fight.
And I love that respect at the end, hey?
Absolutely.
Straight away. Yeah. Straight into it. What an absolute wicked fight. That's fight number two for the night. Oh my gosh. I'm not sure we're going to have a voice at the end of the day.
Well, the crowd's loving it. Where's them?
I was really impressed with the skill set shown by both ladies. Good quality striking. Great, not only great wrestling, but also the cage work, the wall work. That ability to not be taken down was quite good by both girls. And the number of reversals in the second round.
It was like a game of Uno, mate. It was quite a handsome.
And Peter Hickmont here to make it official.
Ladies and gentlemen, another fantastic fight for this evening brought to you by PalmerBet. Please put your hands together for our winner by unanimous decision, out of the blue corner, Cassandra Payday Hay.
And we mentioned it in fight one, it's really, really good to be able to get a good quality three rounds down in your first fight. Just to actually experience the full emotions. I've seen some people, and even myself, in terms of winning a fight early in the first round, you didn't quite get the full experience of sitting down, listening to your corner. You walk out the second fight, you're still kind of a debut fighter in that stage.